guiding you through a chair yoga practice. This is good for anyone who wants the benefits of yoga but can't or doesn't want to get down on the floor for whom it's uncomfortable. You can do this from home in any chair you've got. If you have a straight back chair, great. If you don't, if you're on the couch, maybe just sit forward a little bit so you're sitting up nice and tall, and then we'll get started. Let your hands fall to wherever they fall on your lap. Sit up tall and close your eyes. Take a deep breath in and let it out. And breathe in again. And let that breath out. Coming to be present right now in this present moment, tuning in to our inward sensations. Anything that we can hear or feel or see or even taste or smell. Letting go of our thoughts, of everything going on around outside us. Just being present in this moment right now. Feeling your breath come in. Feeling it leave. Feeling your body shift to accommodate the air coming in. And shifting back as the air leaves. Feeling yourself expanding with every breath you take. And softening, melting into the chair as you exhale. As we move through the practice, we're going to keep our focus here in this present moment, noticing our breath, noticing any sensations we feel in our body, just being here in the practice. Take one last breath here in stillness. And as you exhale, lower your head forward nice and gently, letting your chin fall towards your chest without any strain. And when you're ready, inhale, lift your head up, let it fall to the back as though you're looking at the ceiling. Exhale, bring your chin back towards your chest. Keep that going for just a few breaths. One more breath. And after your exhale, put your head back up to neutral. Let's roll the shoulders. So we'll inhale, lift the shoulders up high by your ears. Pull them back. Exhale, release them all the way back. Again. All the movement and effort is through the shoulder joint and the shoulder muscles. You might find your arms and hands just dragged along for the ride. No effort in them. One more. Let your shoulders come down. Let them go. Nice and relaxed. Bring your hands up to rest up on top of your shoulders, holding on with your fingers. Now we'll circle the elbows. Inhale the elbows forward. Up. Pull them back and open. Exhale, release them all the way down. And then again, we're just drawing big circles with our elbows. Going exactly to the extent that your body feels good going through. Letting your breath be the force that's moving your elbows. One more. At the end of that circle, pause there and switch directions. Inhale, elbows back and up. Exhaling forward and down. Really notice how your breath changes as you inhale and as you exhale. Sigh it out. Your breath naturally getting a little bit deeper and a little bit slower. One more. Good. Then let go of your shoulders. Let your arms hang down beside you, either next to your hips or on the outside. You're going to take a breath, lifting one arm out to the side and reaching up as high as your body wants to go. Exhaling that breath all the way down. And the next side, inhale that arm up. And exhale. as you inhale, feeling this side of your ribs and your waist open and stretch. And exhaling, letting that arm float back down towards the floor. Last time on each side. Inhale, bring your arms straight out in front of you, palms facing each other. Inhale, open your arms out to the sides as far back as your hands want to go. And exhale, bring them back together in the front, reaching forward with your fingertips. A couple more times like that. Inhale, open your chest. Exhale, arms back together. Let your upper back round a bit. One more breath, in and out like that. Let your arms come down into your lap. Shake your shoulders out. Let's let them rest for just a minute. Let's practice getting some movement and some stretch into the forearms and through the wrists. If you have arthritis or any kind of movement issues, you need to stretch that out. Hands either in your lap or right here beside you. We're making almost a right angle with the hand and arm, pressing the palms down into the chair next to you, and breathing through this. I'm not trying to bring them back as far as we can go. Stretching out the underneath side of the forearm here. Take another breath like that. Let it out. Release your arms. Nice and easy. Maybe roll your wrists and hands around a little bit. And then we'll do the same thing, but with the hands tucked under. So we'll put the backs of the hands beside you, underneath. Press the backs of the hands down into the chair or whatever you're sitting on. And if it's hard, don't press all the way down. Go to where you can go. You don't have to have locked arms. If it's hard, lean forward a little bit. And just stretching out the fronts of the arms and the backs of the hands. Breathe here. One more breath there. And let it out. Relax your arms, your hands around in circles. Just clasp the fingertips together. Inverse the hands. And press your palms out in front of you, long, straight arms, stretching the wrists, the palms, and the fingers. If this feels good, great. You can even do it with your arms up, whichever feels good. One more breath. Exhale, relax your hands, let them come back down to your lap. Good. Now we'll come into some sun salutes. You can sit straighten your chair like you are. If you need to, depending on what you're sitting on, you might move a little bit forward so that you have more room with your arms. And inhale, both arms straight up towards the ceiling, hands tucked above your head. Exhale, hands to your heart, and then let yourself fold forward. Upper body leaning forwards towards your lap. This might be as far as you go. That's great, that's okay. If you go farther, fine. Just go to whatever extent you go to. And then inhale, sit back up. Very tall, reaching, expanding, exhale, softening, relaxing. Keep that going on your breath a few more times. Inhale, rise all the way back up. Inhale. Exhale, just take your hands to your heart. Right there. Let your hands come down. Now holding onto the chair or whatever you're sitting on, we're going to lift the knees up, one after the other as we breathe. Inhale, bring one knee up as high as you can go. If it doesn't go very far, don't worry about it. Exhale, press that foot back down to the ground. And other knee, inhale it up. Exhale, press it down. Inhale up, and you can feel not only the leg, but the tummy muscles working to pick that leg up. Inhale. Exhale. I'm flexing my feet. It just gives a little bit more action to the movement. You don't have to. You can let your foot dangle if you make it feel better. Every move we do in yoga is to the extent that you can reach, not to some goal that you think you're supposed to reach. One more inhale. Exhale, press it down. Okay. Let's come and sit forward on the edge of the chair a little bit. We're going to turn sideways. So I'm facing my left. You might be facing your right. It doesn't matter. One knee is bent. Take the other leg and bring it back to a point where we can get that leg mostly straight. If it doesn't go all the way back, don't worry about it. Bring it to the side. You can start it out to the side and then sort of creep it back to wherever you can get it and straighten out that leg. Facing the front bent knee, pressing both feet down into the floor, and you can feel the difference in that. Relax for just a second, then press your feet down to the floor and feel the difference. You feel the leg muscles activate and all the stretch in here. And hold that right there. Arms out. If that's hard, drop them. Doesn't matter. We'll breathe right here. The most important thing that we're doing during this practice is breathing and noticing our breathing. Not trying to achieve the pose. The pose is secondary. But we breathe. We let it out. Notice how that feels. One more breath. Exhale, let your arms come down. Relax this back leg. Let it bend. Get yourself situated on your chair. Now we'll spin around to the other side. Take your time setting up. So now I'm facing my right. Front leg, front knee bent. We'll start to walk this leg back until I can get it mostly straight. Mostly straight, meaning you might have a little bend in it. It's okay. And then pressing both feet down into the floor. Make sure you're steady. And then bring both arms up. Feel how much space you're taking up. Reaching the top of the head up towards the sky while the feet are grounding down into the earth, rooting you through place. And then our fingertips are reaching out to the sides as though we were birds with a really wide wingspan. One more breath. And relax your arms down. Relax this back leg. Let it bend. Come to facing forward. We're going to keep the knees wide apart. Feet flat on the ground. And my feet are at an angle. So that my feet are facing the same direction as my knees. And I'm going to lean forward. Maybe starting with my elbows on my knees. And then bring my hands to the ground. If that's too far down, have something, a stool, coffee table, whatever, to put your hands on so you can go exactly to where you want to go. Let your head hang. It's tempting to hold the neck and the head up. You don't need to. The neck doesn't really have any job right now. Just let it be soft. Take several deep, filling breaths here. Feel your feet pressing into the floor. Take one more breath. Now with the next breath, we're going to inhale one arm out, up towards the ceiling. It's not going to go all the way up, of course. Exhale, bring that arm back down. Other arm, inhale it up. Exhale down. And we just keep that going. We're keeping our hips and our bottom firmly grounded on the chair, so they're not turning at all. They're solid. We're twisting through the waist, opening our chest to one side, and then to the other. One more on each side. Last one. Good. Now as you come up, to protect your back, Bring your hands to your thighs. Use your arms and upper body to push you back up so that you don't wrench your back from the stand. Bring your feet back together. And we're going to stand up. Come to standing. I'm going to move the chair so you can see what I'm doing. So I'm standing facing the chair, both my hands on the back of the chair for stability. We're going to start with warrior one on the right leg. So I'm taking my left foot and I'm going to step it back. I've got my toes and the ball of my foot on the ground. And then I'm going to press my heel down into the ground. So see, it doesn't have to be a very wide stance. And then you can adjust and scoot closer to the chair if you want. Looking straight ahead. Hips and shoulders and chest facing the same direction as the chair. Take a big breath in. And as I exhale, bend the front knee. And just like we did when we were sitting doing warrior in the chair, pressing the feet down into the ground. If you feel steady here, then you can add arms. Bring both arms up. A little bit of a bend in the elbows so that you can pull the elbows back, opening the chest. And if that feels unstable, then just hold the chair. Several big breaths here, feeling the lightness that the air gives you as it comes in. But feeling yourself sink into the ground, into the floor as you exhale. Straighten my front leg and turn towards the side. What I'm doing now, my right foot is still facing the chair, left foot facing straight ahead, so my feet are at a right angle to each other. My feet can be this far apart, they can be wider if you want to do that. And same thing as before, I can bring both arms out or hold onto a chair, whichever. Inhale and exhale, bend the knee towards the chair. Stay right there, breathing, holding onto the chair or letting both arms be up. And again, play with pressing your feet down into the ground, making your legs more active. You can tell if you're just standing, it's a little bit less. If you grip and press your feet down into the ground, it feels a lot more active. You feel a lot more action going on. One more breath here in warrior two. Then we'll move in and out of warrior two as we breathe. Inhale, bring your arms up, straighten the knee, reach high. Exhale, open the arms, sink back down into the knee. And keep that going. One more breath in and out. Hold on to the chair for a second. Straighten this leg. I'm going to push this, my left hip, whichever hip is facing me, push it out to the side a little bit. Arm up and lean over towards the chair. You can put your forearm right here holding on to the chair into triangle. And you'll feel when the knee is bent, it's a lot of strengthening here. With the leg straight, it's a big stretch of the inner thigh and this whole back side of the body. And breathing. I know you're breathing, but are you noticing it? Notice, listen to it. Very easy to forget. That's why we practice. One more breath. Exhale. Use this bottom arm to help push yourself back up to standing. Let that other arm drop. Turn and face the chair again. Just like we were going to do warrior one, turn the back foot inwards, both feet facing towards the front. But now we're going to fold forward through this hip crease, coming into pyramid, and we can use the chair to rest on with our arms. And this is not something you're trying to get to the way it looks. You want to feel, this is a big hamstring stretch. The back of this front leg, down the calf. Breathe into that. One more breath here. feet together. And now we'll switch sides. Same thing, other leg. I gotta spin my chair around. Okay. So left foot forward now. Take the right foot. Step back onto the toes and the ball of the foot. Press the heel down into the ground. Face the chair, hold on to it. Big breath in. Exhale, bend the front knee. Hands holding onto the chair or up. Whatever feels good. Listen to your breath. Feel everything that's happening in your body. Little stretch through your chest and shoulders and upper back. Strength of your legs, feel your feet pressing down into the floor. One more breath. Exhale, take your arms down, straighten this front leg. Hold on to the chair and we'll just open back up to the side. This time the left foot is facing the chair, the right foot has opened, so the feet are at a 90 degree angle to each other again. And inhale, one or both arms out, either one. And exhale, bend the knee. Just like when we were sitting down. There's a lot of work going on in this pose. So breathe. And let the ease be through our breath. Good. Now move in and out of warrior two. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, open. Inhale. Exhale, sink back down. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Hold on to the chair. Straighten out this left leg. Push that right hip out to the side. Come into your triangle. One more breath. Turn back towards the chair, bring the back foot, turn so that it's facing more towards the front again. Good breath in. And exhale, fold forward into pyramid. Again, looking for that hamstring stretch through the back of the leg, the back of the front leg. Standing pose, downward dog. You don't have to move the chair. I'm just moving so you can see me. Actually, facing the chair. I'm going to bend over, put both hands on the chair. Trying to keep my back really neutral, not rounding. And then I walk my feet back just as far as they'll go. And I can walk my hands forward a little bit. Coming into this downward facing dog. So my heels are pressing, pulling down into the floor. They may not reach the floor, but if they do, stretching out the backs of the legs. We're doing the stretch in the upper body, through the back, through the shoulders. Thank you. might be like this, and you might have, you might choose ankle on top of thigh. You're looking for a stretch in this back hip, the piriformis and glutes of the cross leg. So cross the leg, sit up tall, lean forward into that leg. Ah, that's very tight, right there. And if that's too much or you can't get that leg up, come to right here. Just leaning forward is going to give you a lot of stretch right there in that hip. Breathe into that. Every exhale, letting that muscle soften and release. One more breath. Use your hands to push away from your lap. Help that leg uncross, and then switch, other leg. Right here, or if that didn't feel like much, ankle on top of the thigh, and then we're leaning forward. Yes, I feel that too. It's very tight. Okay, some breaths. Let your shoulders relax, let your face soften. Yourself sink into it. One more breath. Push back up, away from your lap, help that leg uncross. Okay. And that's all the movement. Now let's come into the last few minutes of resting. And this is the part people tend to race through, but this is the part, honestly, that we need the most. The slowing down, the relaxing, mindfulness, noticing our breath and our body. So I encourage people to sit as long as they can. If it's hard to sit still, try for a minute, and the next time 2 minutes, and then 5 minutes. Close your eyes and breathe. If you have music you want to put on, you can have that on. You can sit here as long as you'd like. And when you're finished, bring your hands to your heart together. Let your head bow towards your fingertips. Bring your fingertips or your thumbs up to your forehead with a space between your eyebrows. Take one last breath for yourself before you come up out of the chair. May this practice carry you through the rest of your day and the days to come until you tune in again.